In 1975, Steven Spielberg's hit summer blockbuster horror movie came out, Jaws. While launching the famous director's career into stardom, Jaws also gave the American people a long-lasting fear of the water, not to mention man-eating great white sharks. Well, today, I'm here to give you the truth about sharks and shark attacks. Hi, I'm Sarah Brand, McBride's Pride 4-H Club, and today I'll be sharing with you about Shark Attacks 101. I'll be covering three topics: why not to be afraid of sharks, safety precautions for not getting attacked by a shark, and what to do if you find yourself in the water with a shark. First, we'll start with the rather unreasonable fear of sharks. With the media pushing all this man-devouring shark thing, it's no wonder the public is afraid of these interesting aquatic animals. So here are five reasons why not to fear Jaws. In the US, the chance of getting attacked by a shark is 1 in 11.5 million. While the chance of getting killed by a shark is less than 1 in 264.1 million. So just because you see all those people on TV getting attacked, that doesn't mean that you're at sudden risk. That's just a tiny percentage. Number two, almost all unprovoked shark attacks happen just because the shark is curious. Since sharks lack sensitive digits like hands and feet, the only way they can explore an object is to bite it, called obviously exploratory bites. If this happens, the shark will usually just swim away after one bite, though even one can seriously injure a human. Number three, only four shark species out of over 360 have been involved in a significant number of fatal, unprovoked attacks on humans. This includes the tiger shark, the bull shark, the oceanic white tip, and last but not least, the great white. In the last 110 years, there have only been about 104 fatal attacks on humans. That's less than one person a year. This is a chart that I've put together of unprovoked fatal shark attacks in the US. As you can see, it's marked in decades. And for the most part, all the bars are under or just above 10, which would be the average number. And people have asked me why the 1950s are almost double the normal rate. And I tried to do a little research on this, but I couldn't really come up with a clear reason for why. But if you're interested in checking that out yourself, feel free to do so. All right, five reasons why not to fear Jaws. Number five. In the US, the annual number of people who drown is 3,306, whereas the annual number of shark attack fatalities is one. In comparison, 76 million sharks are killed every year by commercial markets. All right, our next topic is shark attack prevention safety. While there is no way to completely eliminate the risk of shark attacks, one may take precautions such as avoiding the water at dawn, dusk, or night when sharks tend to feed. Also avoid overcast days as these can replicate dawn and dusk and sharks are more likely to appear. Avoid areas where sharks generally locate themselves, such as murky water and steep drop-offs. Murky water can especially be dangerous because the two main reasons for unprovoked attacks is because the shark is curious or it mistakes you as prey. And in murky water, that's much more likely to happen. Avoiding swimming alone, always being near a group of people, and if possible, avoiding being at the edge of the group. This can kind of seem like common knowledge, but it can be life-saving if you're attacked. First off, the shark is not as likely to attack a group of people as a single person, and if you are attacked, the people in your group can help fight the shark off. Refraining from excess splashing or movement. Not only will this attract a shark and make you more noticeable, but thrashing around can give you the appearance of being wounded, and to a shark, you're much more attractive prey if you appear as if you're hurt. Preventing pets from entering the water because of their small size and their splashing around, it can easily attract sharks, especially if you're in an area that's infested with them. Avoiding shiny jewelry, which can replicate fish scales, tan lines, and bright clothing because these contrast each other and can easily attract sharks. Avoiding entering the water if bleeding from an open wound. This also seems like common knowledge, but it is true. Sharks are blood creatures. Avoiding areas where prey animals of sharks live, for instance, seals. There have been a number of cases where people have been attacked or killed because they're wearing like a black wetsuit or they're in a group of SEALs, in the middle of a group of SEALs. So, avoiding areas where the remains of fish have been discarded into the water, such as near fishermen cleaning their catch. So, not the best idea to go swimming there. And remember, sharks attack at 2 to 3 feet of water, about 10 feet out from shore. So remember to stay closer than that in shark-infested waters. All right, topic number 3. What to do if sharks are in the water? So what if you're in the water and you spot a shark? Don't panic. Here are some tips to getting out of the water safely. Move gracefully. Avoid splashing on the surface of the water and try to swim smoothly at all times. Avoid sudden or erratic movements as these may draw attention to you, as we discussed, give you the appearance of being wounded. If you see a shark, stay as still as possible. Keep your eye on the shark at all times. Sharks may retreat temporarily and then try to sneak up on you. Don't let this happen. To be able to defend yourself against the shark, you must know where it is, so make every effort to watch the animal, even as you're trying to escape. Get into a defensive position. If you can't get out of the water right away, try to reduce the shark's possible angles of attack. If you're diving, back up against a reef, piling, or rock, any solid obstruction so that you only have to defend attacks in front of you. Fight. Playing dead won't deter an aggressive shark. Your best bet, if attacked, is to make the shark see you as a strong, credible threat. Usually, a hard blow to the shark's gills, eyes, or sometimes snout will cause it to retreat. If you have a stick or a spear gun, use it. Don't use your hands and feet unless it's between that and being lunch. Get out of the water! Well, there are a number of things you can do to ward off a shark attack. You're not truly safe until you're out of the water. If there's a boat nearby, call out calmly but loudly for them to come to you. Stay as still as possible while waiting, unless you're being aggressively attacked. If you're near shore, swim quickly but smoothly. And finally, get medical attention. If you've been bitten, get treatment as soon as possible. Even if your wounds appear minor, it's essential to get yourself checked out. If you're in an area where you can't get to a doctor right away, remain calm so your blood doesn't pump faster throughout your body. All right, in review, I've discussed why not to fear sharks, shark attack prevention safety, and what to do if sharks are in the water. Thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something new about these interesting aquatic animals. If you'd like to learn more about them, these are some websites you can check out. Sharkattackfile.net/species is a website where they have all the recorded shark attacks in the world, I think. And that file is not open to the public, but they do have a page where you can see all the sharks that have been known to have been involved in an attack. And it has kind of a bio on the sharks, their habitat, where they live, and I personally found it very interesting. Sharksworld.com is just a very good general, kind of basic website just for learning more about sharks and the different species and that sort of thing. And of course, if you're really stuck, there's always Wikipedia, even though it's not always the most credible source. And these are some resources I've used in the making of my presentation. And I have some papers here that have the websites I just mentioned. So if you would like one, you can just raise your hand and I'll be happy to give you one. Are there any questions? Yes.
What made you decide to do a presentation on sharks?
The question was, what made me decide to do a presentation on sharks? Well, it's kind of two things. The first thing was probably when I first saw Jaws. And then I started to do some research on it. And then earlier this summer, I went to California to visit my aunt. And I visited an aquarium there that was part of Oceanography Institute. And just kind of those two things just made me more interested in sharks, and I needed a presentation idea, so there we go. Are there any more questions? Yes. Have I ever seen a shark? The question was, have I ever seen a shark? Yes, I have. Not in the water, like in the ocean, but in shark tanks and stuff like that. So, yeah. Are there any more questions? If not, this concludes my presentation. Thank you.